Hello everyone, welcome to the Sea Power Report. My name is Wei, your host. Today's topic, how do modern warships defend against torpedo threats? Owing to the increases in accuracy and the destructive power of torpedoes since World War II, modern shipboard defenses against torpedo threats are still quite ad hoc. Navies are still trying to figure out the most effective and the most reliable ways to counter torpedoes after they've been launched into the water. In the past, during and just before World War II, in the age of the steam and steel gun-based battleships, capital ships, including battleships, relied on anti-torpedo bulges, which are basically water-filled chambers attached to the sides of the ship's hull. These are designed to absorb the shock and the impact of torpedoes after they hit. The idea is that damage and flooding from the torpedo impact would be limited to these torpedo bulges, rather than the ship's internal structure. However, evolution in modern torpedo design, especially in heavyweight torpedoes, have rendered these anti-torpedo bulges largely obsolete, or basically fully obsolete. Modern heavyweight torpedoes do not rely on direct contact with the side of the hull. Instead, heavy torpedoes now detonate under the keel of a warship using proximity fuse, creating a gas bubble that breaks the ship's spine by lifting it upwards and then letting it fall into the resulting vacuum as the bubble collapses. This keel mechanism basically renders the traditional anti-torpedo bulges obsolete, because they can't protect the keel of a warship from the massive shockwave generated by the heavyweight torpedo of modern submarines. So, what do warships do nowadays against underwater threats? Well, the prerequisite to defending against any threat is to know that it is coming, and this includes torpedoes. The first line of defense is underwater situational awareness, and detection can be achieved, for example, through the ship's own sonar systems. This includes the bow-mounted sonar mounted around the boba's bow, or with the ship's towed sonar systems, including primarily the towed array sonar, which mainly enhances the ship's passive sonar detection capabilities. Torpedoes fired from a distance away may also be detected by sonobuoys dropped by friendly aircraft, such as helicopters and maritime patrol aircraft, around a naval task force. The sonobuoys can detect hostile submarines and the act of submarines launching a torpedo, and potentially the sound generated by the torpedo traveling through the water at a warship. In larger and more capable warships, especially dedicated anti-submarine warfare ships, they have tailored sonar systems that are purpose-designed to detect incoming torpedoes, as opposed to hostile submarines. These torpedo alert systems are designed to recognize the unique acoustic signature of an incoming torpedo, giving the targeted ship more time to formulate an effective response before it's too late. So before the ship can devise an effective response against an incoming hostile torpedo, the first step is to detect and preferably to track the torpedo threat. So now that we know the torpedo is coming, what can we do? Well, in cases where the torpedo is fired at a ship at a long range, and assuming that the torpedo is detected early enough, then perhaps the easiest thing to do would be for the ship to try to outrun the torpedo. Under ideal circumstances, this would be the most straightforward, the most effective, and the most low-tech way to try to deal with the torpedo threat. And assuming that the ship can rapidly accelerate to its top speed, it's not hard to imagine how this can work in practice. For example, imagine a scenario where a submarine launches a heavyweight torpedo at a warship, and that torpedo launch gets detected very quickly. Let's suppose the torpedo was fired at a range of 20 kilometers. That's about half of the maximum operational range of a modern heavy torpedo at around 40 kilometers or 50 kilometers. For the sake of argument, let's assume in this case, this is a 40 kilometer range heavy torpedo. We can reasonably expect that this underwater projectile to be traveling at a speed of around 45 knots. I think that's pretty realistic for a heavy torpedo, although the actual speed will vary depending on the specific torpedo. Now let's suppose that the targeted ship is a destroyer with a maximum speed of around 30 knots. Then it's not hard to see that if the destroyer accelerates basically immediately, then it would be able to outrun the incoming torpedo threat. The destroyer would be able to clear the maximum operational range of the heavy torpedo before the latter runs out of fuel or battery power. The torpedo attack would only be successful if it was detected too late by the ship. Therefore, trying to outrun an incoming torpedo is actually a very valid tactic against a torpedo threat, assuming that you have early detection and that the firing range is sufficiently long for this to work. Now, suppose that the torpedo was fired at a much closer distance and that you cannot outrun it. What can you do? Well, the most commonly found active counters to torpedoes can be broadly grouped under what we call soft kill countermeasures. These basically consist of acoustic decoys. They are designed to confuse or to lure the incoming torpedo away from the ship. These decoys are basically all expendable. Some are more valuable than others, but they're all designed to protect something far more valuable, which is the ship. Examples of such systems include the AN-SLQ-25 Nixie, which is the standard torpedo soft kill countermeasures used on US and some allied warships. The Nixie consists of a towed acoustic decoy that is dragged along by a long cable from the stern of a destroyer or a capital ship. It tries to confuse the guidance of an incoming torpedo by simulating the noise of an actual ship, such as the propeller and engine noise. It is designed to respond to a variety of guidance systems, including wake homing, passive acoustic homing, and, to an extent, active homing systems. It is in use on the Arleigh Burke-class destroyers, and previously even on the recommissioned Iowa-class battleships. The UK Royal Navy uses the Surface Ship Torpedo Defense System, or the unfortunately named SSTD. This is also in use by the Adar-class anti-submarine corvette of the Turkish Navy. Similar to the Nixie, the SSTD includes a towed acoustic decoy to draw the torpedo threat away from the ship. However, it also has a pair of acoustic decoy launchers, which launches expendable countermeasures at a longer range. Reportedly, it has a system for identifying the type of torpedo that is coming at the ship, and to devise a counter response accordingly. In a way, the SSTD can be seen as a more comprehensive suite of soft-kill torpedo countermeasure than the Nixie. Now let's suppose that you tried the soft-kill countermeasures to try to lure the torpedo away, and it didn't work. Well, what can you do now? This would be the time to turn to hard-kill countermeasures, to try to intercept the torpedo threat like what you would do against an incoming anti-ship missile. The most concrete examples of hard-kill countermeasures that have actually been put into service have actually been pioneered by the Russian Navy. Let us go through some of these Russian examples to see how they work. The first example that we will look at is the emerging technology of anti-torpedo torpedo system, In the case of the Russian Navy, the technology in question is called the Paket-E ENK anti-torpedo interceptor. This is a lightweight 324mm torpedo with dual functionality. One function, like most lightweight ASW torpedoes, is to find and destroy hostile submarines. The second function is an anti-torpedo interceptor, where the Paket-ENK will track down incoming torpedoes before they reach the targeted Russian warship. The Paket-ENK is usually deployed alongside a special sonar systems deployed on some Russian Navy warships, which is designed to track incoming torpedoes as opposed to hostile submarines. Naturally, both systems complement each other really well with great synergy. As of 2025, most Russian Navy surface combatants have been equipped with both the Paket-ENK torpedo system and the special anti-torpedo sonar. These systems are designed to intercept incoming torpedoes at a long distance, at least a long distance in the context of torpedoes. The elder Russian weapon of relevance for us is the RBU series of rocket-propelled anti-submarine depth charges. These were not originally designed to counter torpedoes, but rather submarines and divers at short ranges. However, they do have some utility in countering torpedoes at close range, so you can think of these as an ad hoc point defense against incoming torpedoes. Basically, a last-ditch effort to stop a torpedo before it reaches your ship. They can saturate a section of the water near your ship with depth charge explosions, creating a preemptive area denial against incoming torpedoes. Sonar systems on board a warship can also help by calculating firing solutions based on the direction and the speed of the incoming threat. This is quite important as the RBU rocket-propelled depth charges are unguided. That being said, the RBU system suffers from several important drawbacks. Firstly, accuracy is quite low because these rockets are unguided. The reaction time available is also quite limited because the RBU series of weapons have only a short range of up to around 4 kilometers depending on the actual variance of the weapon. So the window to intercept is actually very short, and you will only have a few chances of landing a hit. So they are really a last-ditch effort after all other measures at interception have been exhausted. Think of these as sea wizards, but against torpedoes. Hopefully, through this video, you will have learned how warships counter modern heavyweight torpedoes. These include simply trying to outrun the torpedo and getting out of range, soft kill measures to confuse the guidance systems of torpedoes, and lastly, should that fail, hard kill measures for intercepting torpedo threats, of which the Russian Navy can be seen as pioneers.